Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up.
Oh my gosh, I messed up.
If the pitch fails...
Enough talking. Let's vote.
Clearly, none of us like that one. Send him down.
Going down.
Oh my God!
And if the pitch is successful...
It's 3-1.
Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the board.
Yeah!
Yes!
I love elevator pitch.
The judges face off to get the investment.
I'll do what he'll do, but I'll take 4%.
You're trying to mess up our deal?
Which deal you want? Us or him?
Now what you're going to do is destroy this entire opportunity.
Is the next billion-dollar company on its way up? It's Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Sprint Business, with support from The Hartford, Paper and Packaging, How Life Unfolds, and G2, the official pin of Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
This is going to be great. Let's hear the first pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
I'm Rachel. I'm the founder of RX Bra, a medically effective bra that's also cute and comfortable. When women receive breast augmentation, they're required to wear a compression garment for up to 8 weeks. They typically don't because the products on the market are unsightly and really uncomfortable. This causes them to have a lot of complications. I'm a lingerie expert, and I've been making bras for 20 years. I'm a designer, sourcer, and manufacturer, and I wanted to create a product for women that really helped them in a vulnerable time. The RX bra is completely seamless and is made with far infrared yarn. This yarn is like an infrared sauna that increases blood flow and circulation and minimizes scarring. I'm bootstrapped and have $250,000 in revenue with an 85% gross margin and sell to plastic surgeons. I'm looking for $200,000 at a $2 million valuation. Hopefully you're as supportive as my bra.
One, time's up.
Good pitch.
Good pitch.
Great pitch.
So is it really for people that have had surgery? This wouldn't be used every day. It would only be in a rehabilitation type environment?
Sounds like it.
I'm wondering how big that market is. Like how many women have the surgery?
That's the key question.
Yeah.
Because she's successful at it. Good distribution channel through plastic surgeons. Obviously it's directed. But how big is that market? I would assume.
It's a big market for sure.
Enough talking. Let's vote.
All right, looks like you two are out, we're in. Let's open up the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
All right.
Hi, it's so nice to meet you guys. Do you want to see some products, anyone?
Sure.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So when did you launch?
2 years ago.
2 years ago, and you've had 250,000 sales life to date?
Mm-hmm.
What was the sales this last year, though, of the 250?
Probably about 70% of that.
What is the 200,000 going to be used for?
Product expansion. So I sell this to plastic surgeons mostly, and they have requested other sizes, other colors.
And this is only for people that have had surgery or different issues? This wouldn't be for some?
So that's why I made it. But then our customers started wearing it at other parts of their lives. So it has far infrared yarn. So that yarn, similar to an infrared sauna, increases blood flow and circulation and has health benefits for everyone. So it's excellent for maternity when your breasts don't necessarily feel great. And then it also has shown that it can increase lactation. So part of what the funding is for is to do a study for the lactation.
How much is that study?
$25,000.
So I'm curious from a sales perspective, where are they finding out about you?
So most of it's word of mouth.
It is, okay.
Yeah,
so you haven't to date had a dedicated sales team or any kind of representatives?
No.
You haven't done trade shows or associations?
No.
Do you have any idea how large this market is?
So there's about 300,000 women that get breast augmentation, breast enhancement in the US a year.
Great.
And how much does this cost to buy?
$89. So $90 is the retail price.
What is the wholesale?
I sell it to doctors for $40.
$40, okay.
Well, here's what I think you need right now are sales. What I'd be interested in doing is putting in less cash and escalate equity based upon performance. So a deal like that might look like $50,000 in exchange for 10% of the company, and I'll be an advisor and help you build a real sales team because I think that's gonna get you there faster.
All right, wait a second. I wanna use my wild card.
Ooh.
You need cash to get the research done. So if you're open to a $25,000 investment of 5% equity and then some sort of channel revenue for channels that I develop, I'd be willing to offer that with my expertise.
For the capital, would you consider doing 35 for 5%?
35,000, what, the other 10,000 before?
I just know things come up.
Okay, how about this?
Yeah.
As long as the estimate's below 35, that's the cash I'll put in.
Candidly, these are the most complicated things I've ever heard.
Do you have a less complicated deal?
I do have a less complicated deal.
What is it?
I'll give you $100,000 for 10%.
Whoa. Good for you, Peter. That's a lot less complicated.
So you have three offers on the table. Mine's the most simplistic. 100,000 cash, 10%.
My offer is complicated. 5%, I'll pay for the study as long as it's 35,000 and below. And I want a 5% revenue share on the channels that I develop outside of your current channel.
And mine was 50 grand in for 10%. And what I would do is help you develop a sales channel for your product to increase your revenue. It's gonna be easier to raise money once your sales have been increased.
You're really lucky. You have three great offers, but you gotta make your decision.
I'd love to take your offer, Peter.
Money wins. Ooh. I respect that.
We have a
good
deal.
Good choice.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
I can't wait to get started with Peter and move this forward and empower women all over the world. I would give people who are going on elevator pitch advice, just be yourself and highlight the positive things that you and your team like about your company and believe in yourself.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
I'm Carmen Campbell, a mompreneur with a background in corporate sales management marketing, mother of three, and grandmother. My mission is to improve the diaper changing experience when applying sticky, messy, greasy diaper cream to a squirmy baby while on the go. Because it doesn't wash off easily and gets all under your fingernails, I developed a single-handed patented sponge applicator that could be applied with just a pinch, squeeze, swab, and done. Swabbies comes pre-filled with an organic diaper cream that's specially formulated to be safe, fast, and effective without all the mess. We have corporate sales and management. I messed up.
Stay with it. Stay with it.
Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going.
Oh,
no. I messed up.
Let's start over.
Practice and practice is still messed up.
Come on, baby.
Long day.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up.
Reality sets. I'll tell you what, Peter. If she just would have made an ask even, I would have let her up. I don't think screwing up is a reason not to learn more. But quitting, to me, what's she gonna do when things get tough in the business?
I agree 100%. At the end of the day, the show is called Elevator Pitch. You need to deliver a pitch. And even if someone makes a mistake or they freeze, you're exactly right. She had ample opportunity to regroup. A CEO needs to be doing things on the fly, and things are not always going to go according to plan.
It is a good product. I mean, it's interesting.
Yeah, it's an interesting product. Sounds like she's
probably
got some
sense. I also think she's a human, and she made a mistake, and she has something that I'm interested in learning a little bit more about.
Well, let's vote then.
All right, let's vote.
All right, guys, I believe everyone's human, and I want to hear more about this product. Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Happy dance. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
So, Carmen, I'm offering you a lifeline because these guys all said no, but this is your second chance.
Please go for it. Thank you.
I'm Carmen Campbell. I'm a mompreneur with a background in corporate sales management and marketing, a mother of three, and a grandmother. The baby care industry is a $97 billion industry, has 634 million in diaper creams, 8.5 million babies were born in 2017 with 50% getting diaper rash, and we have sales and momentum in the marketplace. We're in e-commerce, retail sales, and all U.S. Bye Bye Baby stores, and we're asking for $500,000 in 20% equity to scale and expand, and we also have a national partnership with the March of Dimes in promoting healthy babies.
I want to hear more.
We're also launching with Macy's.com next month. We launched 2 years ago. We have over 30,000 in revenue, and I've already raised 174,000 with 52,000 of my own being skin in the game. And not only is the baby care market $87 billion, but the elderly market also. So we have the pediatrician who's going to help scale us into the healthcare sector. So you pinch, squeeze, comes to the top of the sponge, you swab it on, you can recycle it or throw it away. It's an applicator with a proprietary organic formula. And we have a patent on the sponge applicator.
It's a huge market.
So I'm intrigued because I just had my first son.
Oh, and congratulations.
We've definitely been having issues with the diaper rash. Do you have to buy your own diaper cream or could use it in other diaper creams?
It comes pre-filled with our diaper cream. We're selling the 2-count pack for $6.95 retail.
What's your cost per unit?
Per unit right now is $1.13, but we're only producing 25,000 right now. And that's part of why we want the investment to produce more products so we have samples to market with.
So you've been up and running for 2 years, but you've just done 30,000 in sales.
Correct.
I like the product, I like the idea. I know that this is a problem. I have a personal issue with this right now.
Right, right.
I think you just need to have a little bit more traction before I would make an offer.
Okay. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you so much for giving me a second chance. I've heard it before, more sales, more traction. So I just got to keep plugging along and doing like I've been doing and continue to raise capital the way I've been raising it and continue to go out and get the sales like I've already been doing and continue to scale the company.
And now, Perfecting the Pitch, presented by Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds.
Tell your story.
While details about your revenue model are crucial, potential investors can become bored with spreadsheets, valuations, and numbers. Make sure you tell your numbers story in a human way. Explain how you came up with the idea and how it changed your life, and talk about your commitment to the brand. Consider creating a short printed booklet or brochure highlighting the key moments of your startup story.
And that will be the best story ever.
Paper and Packaging, how life unfolds. Visit howlifeunfolds.com.
I am totally, totally excited today. This is a dream come true. I've just launched this app and we are so in need of funding. We're in need of scaling and I'm nervous. I'm just ready to do this. So let's go, let's go.
All right, let's hear the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hello, my name is Courtney Coco Eason, and I'm from Nashville, Tennessee, and I'm the founder and CEO of Milk the Moment. My background is in music and entertainment. I used to work for one of the biggest music companies in the world, and I also hosted my own live events and concerts. Now, what I am is the hype girl. I'm responsible for getting everybody out of their seats, hands in the air, and dancing the night away. But I noticed year after year that crowd participation was really, really low, and I found the culprit. It was the cell phone. People were too busy texting, scrolling, taking selfies, or recording the entire event rather than living in the moment, and it drove me insane. But I turned that frustration into innovation and I created the Milk app. Milk is a mobile application that rewards you whenever you refrain from using your phone in places or situations where we should be more present. You are literally incentivized with cash, gift cards, and free products just for putting away your phone and living in the moment. We're asking for $150,000 in a convertible note, so don't miss this moment. Milk this moment.
Time's up.
She was smooth.
Of course, that's her job, promotion.
She was, right? I wanted
to
get up and dance.
She's got an app to not use your app.
Yeah, my problem is literally a phone is more addictive than cigarettes, and there's no incentive program in the world that's going to stop people from smoking or using their phones.
And people want that content. They want to be, you know, they want to have the moment of the selfie and with their friends.
If she has a secret sauce, it would be very interesting.
She didn't say the cap, though, right? She just said it was a convertible note.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
I know enough. Let's vote.
Well, looks like just me and the three of you know. So let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. All right.
Hello.
Thank you.
I loved your pitch, and I thought you had an energy that really captivated me as you were talking. What does this app really do? Because I don't know if I got that.
So how it works is you activate the app by setting a timer in the app. and then you lock your phone and you put it away. And the app is accruing points every minute that the phone is not in use. And once you have enough points, you can redeem those points for a reward inside of the app. We do a lot of this in conjunction with business partners, so movie theaters, restaurants, concert venues.
So is the revenue that you're getting from the brands and their sponsorship,
yes,
and it's free to users?
Right, it's a freemium-based model. We get paid through our connections with sponsors, with restaurants such as Chick-fil-A. We have seven other restaurants in the Southeast area that are on board with us, and we're just trying to scale and get more. It's kind of hard to get them on board because we're in that chicken and egg situation to the, where they want to see.
Literally with Chick-fil-A.
they want to see a lot of different users on board before they jump on board. So it's been a little bit of a tussle.
And you have 14,000 users right now?
14,000 monthly active users.
Monthly active. How many downloads have you had today?
Close to 28,000, 30,000.
Is the company just you?
No, I do have a co-founder and I have a senior developer, and then I have a user experience person and a gaming economist.
Okay, so it's all of you. And have you raised money before?
Yeah, so we've raised money from an accelerator that I just graduated from, $50,000.
What accelerator?
Velocity in Birmingham.
Okay.
And then Google for Entrepreneurs awarded me $40,000 stipend, and then there's $50,000 of my own money put into this.
And then this raises $150,000?
Yes, convertible note.
And what's the cap on the note?
$5 million.
So let's say, for example, you're at an event.
Right.
Is it set up so it can be a location-based app as
yes,
well?
Yes, so GeoFence is regulated into the app. So when you're driving around, it'll tell you that this is a milk zone. That's what we like to call them. This is a milk zone. And then once you go into, let's say, a concert venue, some certain things will pop up in the app dealing with that concert.
What's the sell to the brands?
I'm trying to partner with like insurance firms, schools, movie theaters. And then the second is the eyeballs and the foot traffic that we can bring, telling people, go use it at this restaurant, go use it at this theater, and come back and get your rewards on the next time. So it's kind of a customer retention loop for them as well.
It's a chicken and the egg with me as well. I like you. I like the idea, but I'm not sold that you're going to get the brands to pay what you ultimately want to accomplish. Unfortunately, I'm not prepared to invest at this time.
Okay.
But I would love to stay close. I
yes.
would love to find out if you can lock in a lot of these brands and if you could get more users, start
okay.
cutting some real good deals, then let's have a serious talk.
Gotcha. That makes sense. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate you.
Thank
All
you.
The best.
Thank you.
The judges loved me and they saw that I'm an investable type of founder, but at the end of the day, my company is what needs the funding. And so when people say they like me, but they don't like the business model, it gets frustrating, of course. But we're still working. We're very, very early. And so I think they're going to regret their decision.
Lolly Beauty is the world's first zero-waste organic beauty brand. We're on a mission to stir up the $592 billion wasteful and polluting beauty industry. So we've accomplished a lot since we were on Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch. We've looked at every single part of beauty packaging, from the box that we ship in, to how we package in the glass containers, to the labels we use, the bags we use, and we've innovated on every single piece. Our shipping box is made of 70 to 80% recycled pulp. We then invented this material. It's garden compostable, and it acts like a shipper, you know, protective coating to our packaging. This bag is also garden compostable. I get asked, how worth it was this experience for you? Would you do it again as an entrepreneur? And I have to say, there have definitely been roller coaster moments.
Let's center down.
Center down.
I mean, getting sent down in the elevator, well, that was one of them. But there've also been highs, talking to my consumers and seeing what a difference it's making and how they really feel with their heart that we are changing the world. It's worth it.
Bring on the next pitch.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Jake Press, and I'm the founder of MogoBooks.com. MogoBooks is the easiest way to create beautiful, customizable, and interactive workbooks online. For the millions of online teachers and content creators out there, creating online workbooks means starting with a PDF. Then you have to try to use tech skills to make it fillable. And then there's the printing and distribution, and then how do you actually know who's learning from your teachings? With MogoBooks, we solve all of that. First of all, you don't have to print anything. You simply just create an account, choose your theme, add your content, add your media, add your questions, click publish, and you're good to go. Your members will be able to interact with the content and questions you create Plus, they'll be able to talk to you directly inside your workbooks. We licensed an earlier version of our product for $640,000 to a curriculum publisher. And now we're opening it up to all teaching verticals, and that's where we need your help. We're looking for $500,000 for 20% of our company. Who wants to join us in the $200 billion e-learning industry and empower people to teach what they love through online workbooks? And I can't wait to show you. Let's do this.
Time's up.
That was a pretty good pitch.
Mm-hmm.
I like the business. They already have an implementation for $640,000, like a license.
He said that, but
what they did is they licensed a version of the software, and now he's basically making it available for consumers to create their own content on their platform.
I wonder what the D2C side costs.
Well, the question is, how many more of those 640K opportunities are out there? Do they have revenue from that? And, you know, what's the model look like? So,
well, that's why we have to vote.
All right.
Looks like it's 3-1. Mr. Dave Meltzer, the one. So we need to open these doors and find out more what Mr. Learning Man has to say.
Welcome
Woo-hoo!
To the board.
Day for life, come on. Yes.
All right, welcome.
Right on. I actually have some handouts if you want to just kind of pass out here.
Okay, so talk about this $640,000 deal. Is it still in place? What is that?
Yeah, so the $640,000 deal, that was with a curriculum publisher.
Okay.
That was a two-year deal that ended in 2017.
2017?
Yeah, it was our first license deal. We then generated an additional $170,000 as a company to continue building out the version that we have today. So we expanded it so it could support all teaching verticals today.
So what have been lifetime sales of the company?
So the lifetime sales of the company, total company would be the 640 plus the one plus the 170, and then where we are today on the SaaS side of things.
And what is that?
So the SaaS we've been, which is the subscription model. So we're $39.79 and $300 for the enterprise plan. At the 5,000 paid subscribers at the $39 plan and the 2,500 paid subscribers at the $79 plan, we're going to achieve the $2.3 million mark.
Why have you not really generated revenue in the last 2 years?
So we did $170,000 of custom development projects. Where as a company, we develop custom apps and custom projects for clients, and that's how we've been continuing to fund our own development to get to the product where it is today.
Okay, I understand.
I'll preframe this with, I've produced dozens of products. To me, it's better to have fewer higher-end clients in this space than a lot of lower-end ones and lower ticket. Have you thought about going after a higher-end market instead of a lower-end market and going after more customers?
Yep, that's the specific model which we call sub-libraries. Okay. And sub-libraries is for chapter-based organizations, which there are a lot of them, that want to be able to deliver resources quickly to each of the locations. And there's roll-up reporting all the way to the parent company, which that data is going to be very important.
This is out of like my comfort zone, just that whole like e-learning space.
Okay.
I think it's interesting, but it's definitely not my expertise. It sounds like he has a lot more experience.
Yeah, I've spent a lot of time in this space. In fact, just exited from it months ago. Yeah, I think my discomfort isn't in the possibility or the potential.
Okay.
It's purely in the lack of growth selling this product over a fairly extended period of time.
Yeah.
This is a not right now conversation for me.
Okay.
No offer?
I don't.
All right.
Okay. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you.
Obviously, I wanted an investment, but we've got a lot of great opportunities ahead of ourselves. We've got some new, you know, some potential partnerships currently in the works. So I just want to encourage people to teach what they love online and use mogobooks.com as the platform.
Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Woo! I've got two sets of twins. This is not going to fly.
Our food concept features bone marrow.
Wait, I know that guy.
To apply for season 6, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.